Hello everyone, I'm Öner. Welcome to another tutorial video. This will be a quick tutorial, but I'm sure you will love it. If you are new on this channel, I'm creating 3D architectural visualization tutorials and some tips and tricks. Please check my other videos. Okay, let's start our tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to create a photorealistic parquet floor. I generally use two ways in my works. One of them are using high quality textures, and other one is using floor generator plugin. But in this video, I'm going to create the floor material using high quality textures from Share Textures website. Thank you the sponsor of this video, sharetextures.com. You can find more about Share Textures in the description of this video. Okay. Let's create our floor material using high-quality textures. Now I'm on sharetextures.com and let's type a wood on search bar. As you can see, there are tons of high-quality textures in this website. I think this one is really looking cool. When you click this, there are four maps here. Diffuse, Normal, Roughness and Specular map. You can also download 2K or 4K. 2K is enough for us now. So, let's get back to the max. I created a basic test scene for this video. You can also download this scene to test your materials. The free download link is on the description. But don't forget to give a like and comment please. Okay, let's open the material editor with M and create a corona material. Right click, materials, corona materials. Let's move our textures here. Double click this blue title and have a bigger preview. So, let's add diffuse map to diffuse color. Roughness map to reflection gloss color, but make sure your reflection level is 1 and invert the roughness map. We don't need speckle right now. Click bump and choose a corona normal and then add your normal map here. Double click corona normal and click add gamma to input. Our material looks fine here. Let's assign this to our plane. Choose the plane and click Assign Material to Selection. First, click Diffuse Map and then click Show Shaded Material. Okay, now we see our diffuse map in viewport. Simply close the material library. Our material looks really big right now. We need to add a UVW map on it. Please choose the plane and add UVW map from modifier list. Let's make length and width 100 cm and turn 45 degrees from the top view. Make sure to choose UVW map gizmo and turn the map. Voila! Let's hit the render button. You know what? The material setting is important, but lighting and tone mapping setting is also important. You can easily find the lighting and tone mapping settings for this scene. You can find the download link in the description in the blog. Thank you guys for watching my video. What do you think about the result? Please leave a comment and I will reply all of them. See you on next videos.